Hi, my name is Karen. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you don't know me, I'm an Irish YouTuber living in Ireland. If you do know me, thank you for coming back. I have had a morning. It's been a morning. I could let this morning affect my whole day and I could let it make me feel down, or I could go on the internet and start a fight. And so with that in mind, I'm going to rate the Irish counties. I would like to thank the person on the My Tier Maker website who has this already created for me so I don't have to do it. Thank you. Means I can get straight into the arguing. This video is for entertainment purposes only. If you can't take your county getting absolutely roasted, this video is not for you. Because I want a bite. So first and foremost, I'm obviously going to start with the best county in the country, which is Mayo. There it is, there it is, there she's the best. So up we go to S tier. And actually, what does S stand for in tiers? Superb or super, okay? S tier. Mayo's the best county in Ireland. And that's not biased either. That's not just because I'm from there. But it has... Downpatrickhead. The Cage of Fields. The Humbert Landon. There's history there. Okay? There's lots of history there. It's very pretty as well. It also has a glamping site that has an airplane on it. Let's hope that's not in Sligo. Now, I did consider dropping it a tier because then the Kenny's from there. But I didn't, okay? Mayo is the best county in Ireland. S tier. Now I'm going to do something controversial. I'm going to put Kerry. I'm going to take Kerry. And I'm also going to put Kerry S tier. And that's pretty controversial considering Mayo and Kerry's like GA history before Dublin beat us every year in the All-Ireland. Kerry used to do it. But my mum was from Kerry. Kerry had Fungi the Dolphin, RIP. Miss you Fungi every day. Then also I got engaged in Kerry, and again it's not biased, we got engaged in a place called Clarney Park, which is very pretty. Shut up. It's not biased, okay? So who have we got next? We got Donegal. Okay, so I'm gonna put Donegal A tier. The reason I'm putting Donegal in A is because Donegal, while it is not in Northern Ireland, it's up north, if that makes sense. It is in Ulster and it is the best, like objectively the best county in Ulster, because it still has the Ural and their accents are class. And I'm sure there's other stuff also happening in Donegal, things to do in Donegal. Oh, Bundoran is in Donegal! Okay. Bundoran's the best surfing spot in the country. Would I make it S tier because of that? No. No, 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 no. Every county can't be S tier, Claire. And also, we're in a bad mood. I thought I was starting a fight and I'll be nice to every fucking county. Kildare. Okay. Sorry, Dad, I love you, but I'm gonna put Kildare in F tier. So first of all, their GA team's utter shit. It's basically a commuter county. Kildare is also where they train all the priests. F tier. In my humble opinion, there's nothing happening in Kildare. When are they ever like, ooh, we're gonna have this big event and it's in Kildare? Never. It's just McDonald's and Rhodes. That's what Kildare is. So we're gonna go to Sligo. And I'm going to put Sligo in D. I'll tell you why, because I think it's like a mid-tier county. There's nothing offensive about Sligo, you know? It has some good stuff going on, but at the same time, if you said, I'm moving to Sligo, people would be like, oh, not Galway? Kilkenny. I'm also going to put Kilkenny D tier, because I know nothing about Kilkenny. But I do know that they're mad for the hurling. Also, actually, Kilkenny has a reptile zoo, so I'm going to move Kilkenny up to... No, I'm not. It's still going to stay in D, actually. Even a reptile zoo can't save it. I'm going to go with Wicklow now, and I'm going to put Wicklow in A tier. And the reason I put Wicklow in A tier, again, not biased. I put Wicklow in A tier because it's got the Wicklow Mountains, right? Which you can walk to from Dublin, by the way. And when my dad used to bring me to Wicklow Town when I was younger to visit my cousins, he used to bring me down to the shop. He used to buy us all Cornettos. And that's one of my favourite childhood memories. So Wicklow is getting A tier. I feel like I didn't give it S tier because when I used to go to Wicklow as a kid, we used to always drive over the mountains. And so it was a very little bit of a nerve-wracking experience, to be honest with you. But also, it felt like it took forever to get there. I know that there's a motorway there now. Actually, honestly, that would nearly bring it down to B tier for me. It's too accessible. It's no longer mystical. Oh, also, I should really be looking up the history. Doors to the Other World, the Fairy Folk of Ancient Wicklow. I'm kind of tempted to put it up to S tier because of that. No, I'm going to stick with my initial thoughts. A tier. A tier is fair, is a fair review. Carlo, F tier. Leash, F tier. Honest to God, like who do you know from Carlo or Leash that contribute anything to society? What's going on in those two counties? Nothing. Loud. F tier as well. Okay, so County Clare, right? I'm going to put County Clare in B tier. And I'm putting it in B tier because it's got the Cliffs of Moher, it's got the Aloe Caves, and it has the same name as me. But what else has it got going for it? Tipperary has a song, what does Clare have? Speaking of Tipperary, Tipperary is going to go to E tier because it's a long way away. Mead, F tier. Like, what's in Mead? Nothing. Like, you move to Mead, you can't afford to live in Dublin. Again, videos for entertainment purposes only. Like, if you can't take me in Rustin. Okay, Westmead. So actually, I'm going to do something controversial here and put Westmead in C tier because Westmead has Athlone. And Athlone is grey crack. All my friends went to college there. They have a really good nightclub that I can't remember the name of right now. Athlone is actually great for a midway meeting point. Like, we got married actually in Westmead. Oh yeah, Mount Druid is in Westmead. Oh, I still think C tier is fair. I think it's more than fair. Leitrim, I'm going to put Leitrim in E tier. The only reason I put it in E tier is because of the accent. Oh, am I thinking of the Limerick accent? Oh, I think I'm thinking of the Limerick accent. Yeah, Leitrim gets F tier. Like, what's from Leitrim? Okay, so we've got Roscommon, also gets F tier for me. For me, Roscommon is a poor man's Westmeath. What have we got? We've got Wexford. Okay, I'm going to put Wexford in E tier because it has a... I like purple and I like gold. But it also gets put into E tier because Wexford people are too in your face about Wexford. I'm going to get so much trouble now and tag next thing. Limerick. So I'm going to put Limerick on B tier. I'll tell you why I'm going to put Limerick on B tier. It's only 2 hours from Dublin. And anywhere that you can get to within 2 hours of Dublin is immediately on my higher list because it just makes my life so much easier. It's got really good sporting facilities. A lot of the sport that I play actually ends up in Limerick. The people are good crack. They don't take themselves too seriously. I know where you thought I was going to go with my Limerick comments, but I'm not actually going to go there because Limerick had a really bad reputation a couple of years ago. The joke was it was called Stab City, but they really put like loads of money into it, really worked on improving it, and now it's like a really nice place. Don't shoot the messenger, but from an outsider's perspective, Limerick seems a lovely place to be. It's very clean, like it's great crack. They've got great places to go on nights out. They've got great sporting facilities. I have been to Limerick lots of times and I've never seen any of the negative stuff that still sort of permeates the Limerick public perception. So Limerick gets B tier for me. I've nearly talked myself into moving it to A tier. They have such good nightlife, such good sporting facilities. They've also got really good shops. Pig and Porter is also there. I'm moving Limerick to S tier because of its prevalent tag rugby scene. Yeah, I did that. Limerick's on S tier now. I did that. I just did that. Okay, Galway. So I'm moving Galway to S tier as well. When I was growing up in Mayo, it used to always be a big deal to go to Galway shopping. It was like the only big one bigger than that was Dublin. The very first county I played tag for was Galway and I had a brilliant time. It's right beside Mayo. So if I lived there, I'd be very close to home. When I was in college, a lot of my friends were in college in Galway, so I have a lot of really debaucherous memories from Galway, including food fights in supermarkets, which are like a rite of passage as a student in Ireland. Obviously they've got Air Square and they've got loads of fucking, you know, sightseeing and shit, and like it's Galway. Like, you know, it's like I'm gonna put fucking Mayo on S here. They can't not put Galway up there as well. And also because Galway as well has tag rugby and touch rugby as well, and is still into the GAA, and it's the home of Connacht rugby, and the sports ground is there. Galway is absolutely S tier. I'd live and go in a fucking heartbeat. Waterford, E tier. They've got Crystal. Offaly, F tier. What's going on in Offaly? The National Ploughing Championships are in Offaly. They have the Ploughing Championships, and actually the Ploughing Championships are great crack. And it's literally what it says in the tin. Like, it's people, they bring their tractors and they plough fields and they compete for, I don't know, trophy or something. And then they also have like sheepdog trials and sheep shearing competitions about how fast you can shear sheep. I would love to go back to the Ploughing Championships again. So I'm going to pull up Offaly to C tier, just based off the back of the Ploughing Championships. It's my list, okay? It's my list, and the criteria does not have to be set, okay? It can be totally fluid and can change by the minute if I wanted to. We're going to go with Cavan. Also F tier. again, what's going on in Cavan? Like, all we got out of Cavan was a load of Cavan man jokes that are not funny. It's like shitty TikToks. Armagh. Antrim is good for the old tourism, isn't it? Antrim. I feel like, isn't the Carrickaridi rope bridge in Antrim? So I'm going to give Antrim B tier. It also has, I believe, the Giant's Causeway. Oh, I should probably put that higher. Okay, it's got moved up to A tier because the Giant's Causeway. Let's hope it's actually in Antrim. Armagh and Tyrone are all getting D tier because I'm sure that there are like really cool things happening up there, but I don't like these in pounds. So they're in D tier because I haven't explored them enough to really be able to slag them off. I'm going to give Monaghan D tier as well to avoid getting in trouble. Let's do Dublin, because I'm sure that's the one you've all been waiting for. Dublin is, at best, B tier. And that's being kind. If you're a sporty person, you'll be able to find a sport in Dublin. It also has loads of bars, stuff going on. But it's also packed. Even though it's really small, it can take you an hour and a half to get from A to B because of traffic. And the government is in Dublin, and all they fucking think about is Dublin. And that's great for Dublin, isn't it? I love it. But also, it's not the country. It's Dublin. You know what I mean? It's Dublin. As a culture, I just can't bring myself to give it anything higher than a B. So yeah, Dublin gets B tier and you can't fucking convince me otherwise. So I put Limerick in S tier, Galway in S tier and Dublin in B tier. So I'm not going to live that one down in the tag scene for quite some time. Got four counties left and I've no idea what their flags are. Well, that's Cork. How could I forget Cork? Cork is definitely... F tier. It's my list, okay? Cork is F tier. When you go to Cork City, it's this one-way system that goes around. It's really annoying, actually. Okay, Sligo's already D tier. I was about to drop it a tier for the same reason. The fucking one-way system is so annoying. Also, Cork people think Cork is so great. Like, you're wildly overhyping it. I'll tell you what. I'm going to move Cork up to D tier. Simply because I've Sligo, Kilkenny, Fermanagh, Armagh, and Tyrone in D tier. And that feels to me like a very fair line of counties. Then I've got three counties left and I have no idea what they are. So I finally figured out what the last three flags are and I literally had to write out a list and mark off all the ones that I had already done to figure it out. The last three are Longford, makes sense why I forgot it, Derry and Down. And so we'll go for Down first. I'm going to put Down in A tier with Antrim because Belfast straddles Antrim and Down. Belfast for me is one of my favourite places in Northern Ireland. I've done so much there. I've done a couple of Game of Thrones tours. I did a Segway tour. I did like a Sky Trek thing. I just think that Belfast is amazing. And therefore, Antrim and Down both get joint credit for that. So they're both in A tier, up there in A tier. Then we've got Derry. They do have a vibrant Irish scene connection with Irish music and culture. Like in Derry, you've got the walls and you've got the murals and you've got all that history. And then of course there's all this argument about whether it's called Londonderry or not. So basically what I'm gonna give it C tier. And last but not least, Longford. What is Longford other than an axis by which people go to other places? What happens in Longford other than flooding? You know? Fights. I'm going to put Longford in F tier. Wow, I have a lot of counties in F tier there, really, don't I? Kildare, Carlow, Leash, Louth, Meath, Leitrim, Roscommon, Cavan and Longford are all in F tier. I will move Longford to E tier because at least it has the flooding, you know? There's a story that I do tell it quite a lot. It's the story of when in college I figured out how to get strange men in pubs to stop talking to you. Normally you'd be in a pub and a guy would come up to you and one of the first things they'd say is like, where are you from? And then that would start a conversation. And I discovered through trial and error that there were some counties that ended the conversation if you said them. Carlow and Cavan. Louth and Leash were among those counties. They just said them and then the person would be like, oh. Whereas if you said Mayo, they'd be like, oh, hard luck, never winning Sam. There was just a couple of counties where the conversation ended and you said them. And so they're all in F tier. Although, realistically, maybe I should move them up because they did get me out of quite a few conversations I didn't want to be in college. Okay, so that is my ranking of the counties. It's been fun. Not being cancelled, but I guess that's over now. Why don't you leave your thoughts in the comments below? What county have I badly done dirty here? Give me your full unabridged thoughts on how fucking wrong I am about where I put this one specific county. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, you might like the video where I rated Irish crisps. Or you might like my series where I go to all these counties to do fun things that are on in these counties. And then come here and say, no. Please consider supporting the channel on Patreon. Not only is it how I keep the lights on and how I keep being able to create content full time, but I also create extra content on there. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Slán slán.